Hey guys, it's recap time. Let's get this started. Take a look. We're going to start this one off by going all the way back to last Sunday. And that was when I got to show you guys the Vitavon diff cases for the Mojave. Now, these diff cases are really nice. The reason why I like them, when you buy the diff cases, you get the part that comes in the top as far as that holds the diff into place, so it's not two separate pieces. You buy one part, you get the whole thing. And they help hold the pinion gear in place, and they got a bigger input bearing than what the stock box has. So that's all plus. They hold the pinion in place better. The mesh stays better with the ring gear. I believe I may have just mentioned that. And heat dissipation. They dissipate the heat from the gears because there is friction there. No matter how much you pack them with grease, there is heat there, and that gets transferred to the case and to the chassis. So yeah, that giant chassis is also a form of a heat dissipation, kind of heat sink-ish, sort of. Anyway, I'm happy with those boxes from Vitavon. The Traxxas Max. I got to put this thing through its paces. As you'll notice, I've already got that wide kit on. So yeah, I absolutely love the wide kit. The truck should have came with the wide kit to begin with. It's that good. So hopefully, with any luck, today you guys will see the wide kit install and drive. So I'm happy with that. The Wendigo got a new rear sway bar by Reefs. I showed you guys the install on that. And although that did stiffen up the back just a little bit, it still allowed it to articulate. I was able to take the rear sway bar and put it on the front. So now it has front and rear sway bars on that. And that's the way it's going to stay. I like the handling a little bit better. With just the stock sway bar on the back, it torqued really, really bad in my opinion. So now it doesn't torque quite as bad and it stays flatter. It just handles better, put it that way. I like it, and I'm keeping both sway bars at both ends. Or a sway bar at both ends. Yeah. I took the X-Max out to Extreme RC Club of Jacksonville, Florida. It's out off of Cecil by the Cecil Airport here off of Normandy. Now, was having some fun with it. Put it on the oval. The tires were not happy. And on the drag race, well, this happened right here. I was able, now listen to this right here. I was able to do some trading and all, and I got a replacement tire. Another 8S tire. Now, evidently, me running the big Castle motor, the slightly faster but way stronger setup that it is, the other three tires are expanding a lot faster and bigger than this tire is. So I'm just assuming that I'm actually slowly destroying the stock tires with, you know, all that expansion. So, but yeah, all three of the others will expand twice as much as this one will at this point, which this one expands about as much as these did when it started. So I think what we're seeing is the stretch and deterioration of the stock tires. So I've been looking around. You guys have been giving some great suggestions. I kind of like the Duratrax lockups. I was able to see a few of those local, but man, right now it is hard to get tires. You almost got to know somebody with a spare set or something to get them. I mean, the local hobby shop, they sent me a picture of what they had, but it wasn't really something that I really, really wanted. You know, I want something super aggressive. I could get the Pro Lines again. I've already had them. I just want something a little different. So that's the only reason why I'm not getting the Pro Lines. Now, I'm saying that now. You guys may see this thing 2 weeks from now, and it may have Pro Lines on it. I don't know, but I am keeping my options open for some different tires. I recently sold my other Capper, so this is what I've got to start out with, fresh and new. It's probably going to be a slow build, maybe some nice parts here and there. I'm going to try to keep it simple. I may just keep it front steer only, actually. I may just keep it that simple, just to take it in a different direction than the maximumed out, you know, four-wheel steer, everything you can put on it, you know, at least for what I saw was useful. There are a lot of mods for the Capra out right now. A lot. And a lot of them you can buy them bolt in. They're just crazy mods for it. I kind of want to keep this one simple but effective. So will it get some brass? Yeah, probably. But I don't plan to go overboard with it. I would like to put some aluminum axles on this. Not sure what to go with just yet, but if I do go with that, it'll be more for durability. If you recall with the other Capra, I actually broke it quite a few times right down here at the C. So, and that was from trying crazy lines and coming down and smacking like this. When you smack whack like that, it just can really break that. But the point of it being up here right now is I put a 444 servo from Reese in this thing. Now, I put it in, I didn't do any mods, still got the stock radio, which I don't really care for. That's going to come out soon. But, yeah, the stock ESC was just enough to hold that servo and make it work. I knew I was stressing out the BEC inside the stock ESC. I know it wasn't happy. You could tell it. There were a few spots where it's like, okay, something just happened, just a little bit. Probably not noticeable on camera, but I could just feel it, you know? So, anyway, it's going to get a new system of some kind. I'm not exactly sure what just yet, but it will get a new motor, a new ESC. I'll probably do that, little fuel cell thing on the back so I can fit more stuff in the side. I like that. And obviously, some wheels and tires. Now, I've seen a few guys post up that the stock tires actually break in really nice. I know I'm having some luck with the SEX 10-3 tires breaking in pretty well and working. I don't know. We'll have to see about these. See if I keep them or if I ever build that trailer I want to build, I'll have a nice set of tires for that. Anyway, that was my Capra. Optimus 3 got a Hobbywing Axe 2300 kV system in it. I love the Hobbywing Axe. I love how it works. I love the control. I love just how the thing feels with that system in it. Whether it's a 23, the 27, or the 3300. And although I think it done really good, I missed the feel that I had with the old system. Now, previous to the Axe, it was running a BRXL ESC. And the reason I went with that is because I wanted to have the option to go 4S. For some reason, I wanted to make the truck 4S capable, and it is with the BRXL. Obviously, the Axe is only good for 3S. But the motor was just a $20 Crawlmaster Sport 12-turn, 550 size, and it actually worked really, really good. So, I think the end game for this truck, as far as motor and ESC, is going to end up being, whenever I can get one, the Holmes Hobbies 16-turn Magnum. I feel that is going to be the end motor for this truck. And I'll go back with the BRXL ESC with the external BEC. Maybe. Don't know if I'll do the BEC again, because now that I've got the 777 servo up front, I really don't need it. I can just run the Micro 99 for the dig right off of the ESC and be fine. I think I just came up with a game plan, guys. I saved the prettiest for last, the Clodbuster. After last week's recap, I put this out on the same day, which was a Saturday, and the video done good. You guys liked it. So, and in all honesty, I enjoyed recording it. Driving this is not like driving an X-Max. It's not like driving a Wendigo. It's not like driving anything. It's just big, square, top-heavy, and clunky. But it's a driving that's just so different from normal driving. it's not mega powered. It's not brushless powered, in which you can do that to all this. I mean, you could make the thing probably just about do a standing backflip if you just really want to get nutty with it, but I don't. I mean, I've got stuff. I'm going to check something. Okay. The tires are not even glued to the wheels. So I wasn't sure if they were glued or not, but I didn't think they were. But yeah, this thing is just a nice truck. I like it. Hopefully you guys like it too, which you guys seem like you did. I don't have much news for you, but what I do have to say is all the Reef servos, because I do a lot of Reef stuff in here. And the reason I do the Reef stuff is quite simple. It works so well, especially in my trucks. So, I mean, believe me, if a product was not top of the line, it would not be in my competition trucks. Simple as that. You know, I'm not going to put a weak or a servo that fails a lot in a competition truck. I value my competition scale trucks. I value winning. So that's why I run them in there. Now, the Reef servo lineup, as I understand it, all the servos are about to get new cases and will be fully programmable. So if you've been putting off that servo buy, if you've been looking at Reef and hey, you want to step it up, well, it's about time. Not sure whether it's going to be a week, 2 weeks from now. This whole pandemic thing is kind of affecting a lot of stuff. It's hard to get some things that we used to take for granted. But anyway, they're coming. As far as upcoming videos go, I have a long list of things to do. You know, I'll knock that list down, you know, to where it's about halfway and then everything else comes up. One of the things I've been trying to get is another video with the Mojave. I want to take this 1250 kV motor out, the one I put in from the Creighton 8S, leave the Creighton ESC in. However, I want to take this motor out and put it in the Limitless. The Limitless has a Hobbywing 1650 kV, and I'm going to put the 1650 kV into the Mojave. The reason is I want this truck to perform on 6S, but I don't want to have any heat issues. And I believe the 1650 with the 20 tooth pinion will be perfectly fine for what I want to do. I don't need, you know, 80 miles per hour. I just don't. But what I do want is a good, solid 55 to 60. Now, the 1250 kV motor that's in here, with the 8S on it, I was able to get, I believe it was 59 miles per hour in a grass field. That's pretty good. When I test these off-road trucks, I use the field for that. Could I get more and be more impressive if I put them on an asphalt surface? Sure, but that's an off-road truck. I mean, if I redesigned it or something and made it an on-road race truck, then it would be different. But it's an off-road truck. It's supposed to be getting air, turning donuts. So that's how I test off-road. So guys, I'm going to wrap this video up. Been talking way too long. You know, these recap videos, it's kind of crazy because I'll go into them and I'll be like, okay, I got nothing to talk about. And then I start looking at the videos from the past week and I end up just talking forever. Believe me, every time I get up here for this, it's like, I got nothing to talk about. It was just an average week. Then I look at everything I did. I'm like, wow, that was a lot. And yeah, so we're at the end of the video and now I'm going to tell you about my affiliates. Haha. If you notice, if you look in the description, you know, I've got the affiliates for A-Main Hobbies, eBay, and Amazon. So if you have something in your cart, you can go check those websites out and check out. It gives a commission. Well, below that is actually where you can buy this shirt. You can actually get this shirt through Teespring. And I've got a whole bunch of different colors and all kinds of stuff like that. Hoodies, towels you can get. So anyway, that link is in there. Below that are other links, and these are other affiliates that I have. So everything from tactical gear to baby products. Let's see, one of them is a TV service, Bitmar. I'm actually going to get that service, actually. I'm going to get it so when I get to do the video, because I want to do a video on that specifically, but before I can actually do that video, I need to get the service so I know exactly what I'm talking about. But that link is down there as well, and it's $50 for life, which is kind of crazy to me. Just pay $50 and you got TV for 20 years. I don't know, but that's pretty darn awesome. Anyway, check that description for affiliate links. And guys, as always, thank you very much for watching.
If you guys like what you see, make sure you're subscribed. Hit that subscribe button and ring the bell. If you really, really like what you see, consider clicking on that join button down below. With that, you can actually become a channel member. Members get early viewing of many of the videos and, you know, a little bit more personalized. Guys, thank you all for watching.